Hello and welcome to the 9th video of my L4D2 mapping tutorial series. Today we'll be going over Vscript, specifically director scripts. The word script alone may strike fear into some, but trust me, what we're dealing with is way easier than you think, so stick around. Vscripts are text files that can be written to create advanced functionality, like the crazy stuff you see in mutations. By far the most common use case in L4D2 is to influence the director. We'll call these director scripts. Director scripts come with a lot of built-in options to change how the director behaves, like spawning 100 zombies, allowing 5 chargers to spawn, and more. Because it's all built in, director scripts are very easy to create and modify. What's even easier than creating your own is modifying an existing script to your liking. In the description is a download to all of L4D2's default vscripts decrypted, so that you can open them and copy what you like. Vscripts have the .NET file extension, but they can be opened in Notepad or any plain text editor. Let's say you have a huge, foggy outdoors map like Swamp Fever. Even through this thick fog, zombies will refuse to spawn through it, because survivors technically have line of sight. We could fix this by using a director script. Looking through the zip we downloaded, there's a script called c3m1_swamp_fog_spawn.nut. Opening it up in Notepad reveals we have a line that says zombie spawn in fog equals true. Along with that, we have a setting to change how far zombies can spawn. For demonstration purposes, let's use this script as a base for our own. Navigate to your L4D2 game files. You could do this by opening your Steam library, right-clicking on L4D2, hovering over Manage, and clicking Browse Local Files. Open the folder that says L4D2 in all lowercase, and then open up the Scripts folder. Make a new folder in here and name it Vscripts in all lowercase. Inside the Vscripts folder, make a new text document. Now if you can't see .txt at the end of the text file, click View at the top of the File Explorer and check File Name Extensions near the top right. Now select the whole name and clear it, then give the file an appropriate name, followed up with .NUT as the extension. Open back up that c3m1_swamp_fog_spawn.nut script and select everything, then copy and paste it into our new script. The message line is what will be printed to the console when the script starts. Change it to something appropriate for debugging purposes. So we already have the zombie spawn in fog set to true, we can now change the zombie spawn range option to whatever we want. By default, this option is 1500, and it's measured in hammer units. Big maps will likely need to go over 2000. Small maps don't need to change this value and can safely delete it from the script if so desired. Now we have our own script. Great, let's put it to use in our map. This script is meant to be used passively at all times, so we can call it right when the map loads with an entity called logic_auto. This entity has outputs that fire automatically on various chosen conditions. Place one down and open its outputs. Make a new output on map spawn, which fires when the map loads or is restarted, targeting the info_director entity, which should just be named director. Via this input, begin script, with a parameter of the script name. The script name I'm using for this video is tutorial_script, so I'll put that in without the file extension. Compiled and in-game, if we scroll up in the console, there's the message that says our script is running. If you ever want to end the script and return to default, you can fire the end script input to the director. You can also start a new script, which will end the current one. There's so many more things you could do with director scripts. In the description is the Valve Developer Community Wiki page that lists all the possible options you can add. Very helpful. To prevent you from getting overwhelmed, I'll be going over the most commonly used options you can put in your scripts. First one is reserved wanderers. Wanderers are the idle common infected that spawn around the map. When a panic event or a random horde occurs, all the wanderers may get culled to be used for the horde. This can result in jarring moments where you see zombies in front of you, turn around, and turn back and see they're all gone. The director options always allow wanderers, and numb reserved wanderers can fix that. Let's type these two in between the curly brackets. Set always allow wanderers to equals true, and num reserved wanderers to equals whatever integer you want. The amount you set is the amount that won't get despawned for hordes. Second, the prohibit bosses option. This prevents tanks and witches from spawning. Put it in there and set it to equals true if you want. Third is the common limit option. This tells the game how many common infected can be alive at once. By default and without this option declared, the limit is 30. Do not get carried away with this option. It may be funny to set it to 300, but unless you're making a joke map, it's not fun and lags PCs and servers, so you may not even need to include this option in most scenarios. Increase this limit if you have a big, wide open map. Don't ever go past 50 with this option in normal circumstances. Fourth is the preferred mob direction option. This dictates where hordes are preferred to spawn relative to the survivors. Should they spawn far away from the survivors, in front, behind, close by, the choice is yours. The wiki page lists some flags here, but scrolling down shows there are even more you could choose from. Fifth option is disallow threat type. This lets you choose to prevent either tanks or witches from spawning. Simple. Either use zombie underscore witch or zombie underscore tank. Sixth and last we'll go over is zombie discard range. This option gives the director a distance for when to safely despawn common infected that the survivors have passed and ignored. The default value is 2500. You'll want to correlate this with your zombie spawn range value. If you had a spawn range of 2700, you'd probably want to set the discard range to 3200 or above. Not too high though, otherwise commons won't despawn and they'll be hogging a spot on the limit that can better be used elsewhere. That's all the options I'll cover in this video. There are hundreds of options you can put in your director script, so covering all of them would easily take over an hour. As for vscripts / director scripts as a whole, we'll be needing to use these when creating panic events and finales. Speaking of panic events, next tutorial we'll be going over panic events, the different types, and how to create them. Thank you for watching.